In the previous lectures, we have been introducing the topic of the master production schedule, a key phase in the whole production planning cycle. From a practical point of view, the master production schedule appearance is that of a multidimensional space in which, depending on the plan or production line, on the time bucket to be considered, and on the production family, a given quantity to be produced has to be designed. This is very complex problems which cannot be done manually or by simply iteration. And so several methods have been developed in literature and in operational research and in general applied mathematics and computer science in order to deal with this problem. In this lecture, we will introduce the topic of linear programming as a way to elaborate the master production scheduling. Linear programming is a powerful technique for the optimization of problems that can be formulated using only linear equations, and both for the objective function as well as for the constraints. In its canonical form, you have to optimize or maximize or minimize the product of some decisional variable x multiplied by an array of coefficients which express their importance in terms of the objective function. And this objective function can be a profit optimization, maximization, or dually a cost minimization. Moreover, through linear equation, you have also to express a set of constraints, so Ax smaller than b. And this set of constraints can be used to express, for instance, production capacity limitations or inventory limitations and so on. Usually, the x decision variable belongs to the real numbers. In order to illustrate the application of linear programming to MPS, let me use an example. Let's assume a very simple supply chain in which you have a manufacturing plant in which products I have to be produced in a set of given period T, plus a warehouse in which inventories of this item I are stored in order to serve the demand. Demand coming from the market, which is perfectly known. Other assumptions in this simplified model is that the demand is deterministic and we are dealing with a multi-product situation, but no setup time or cost have to be considered. Moreover, also stockout occurrence is avoided because the accumulated capacity is greater than the accumulated demand. The only costs to be optimized are material costs, labor costs, for instance, considering both regular time and overtime, and inventory holding costs. And the main constraints to be considered is the workforce capacity. In order to explain the application of these methods, let's start from the objective function. The objective function, we will have three components. One related to variable cost, one related to inventory holding cost, and the other one related to workforce cost. More specifically, each of these items is obtained as the product for every product and for every period of the decision variable, so the quantities to be produced, multiplied by the unit material cost or the unit variable cost. The same for inventory holding cost. We have a variable expressing the quantity to be held in the warehouse at the end of the period to be multiplied by the unit inventory holding cost. And let's assume that all these costs can be depending both on items and on period. Eventually, workforce costs are expressed as the product or capital W and capital S, so the amount of used hours both in regular and overtime, each of them multiplied by the unit cost of regular workforce and overtime workforce hour. As for the constraint, let's start with the inventory or materials balance constraint. This constraint very easily connects the production, the inventory position with the demand. It can be expressed for every item and for every period to be considered in this way. So the inventory at the end of a given period is equal to the inventory at the ending of the previous period plus the quantity we have been producing, diminished by the quantity of the demand we have been serving. Then you have also to express capacity limitations constraints, which is easily done in this way. So you multiply the producer quantity X by the unit manufacturing hour time, which is expressed here by the H letter. The capacity limitation constraints is expressed through this balance equation in which we have on the one hand the used manufacturing hours, so the product of quantity produced time the unit hours needed to produce a given item I in a given period T, and on the other hand the total amount of capital W and capital S, so the number of hours used both in regular and overtime. Of course, capital W and capital S, they have to be bounded by zero on the one end and by the maximum amount of hours on the other end. Eventually, we have the last constraint, which is the fact that inventories always have to be greater than zero, so that we ensure we have no stock out. And as usual, non-negativity constraints, so as to avoid that negative values are set for the production plan. Once the problem has been formulated, the subsequent step is that of reaching a numerical solution. This can be done depending on the problem size in different ways. For instance, for very small optimization problems, you can use general productivity tools such as a Microsoft Excel spreadsheet and using embedded solvers. On the other hand, if the problem size is very large, you have to resort to specialized tools, which could be application or even libraries available from commercial vendors or from open source communities. Linear programming is a very flexible methodology. In this way, for instance, you can make more complex model of your whole planning problem. For instance, you can try to understand what happens in a multi-echelon production problems in which you have two production stages separated by two inventories. In this example, you see from the sketched equation how easily can be adapted the formulation by simply rewriting the materials balance equations. You can also introduce more elaborated cost function. For instance, you can remove the assumption about no stock out, introducing lost sale costs, or even you can introduce more stringent constraints, for instance, perishable inventories. You can try this at home once you have been practicing a little bit with linear programming. The most important part is that you can even go to more complex problems by using discrete decisions. Let's consider, for instance, a problem in which we have setup times or setup costs affecting the manufacturing decision. That is, any time a product is put into production in a given period, a given cost has to be paid. In this case, the first part of the objective function has to be modified as follows by introducing a setup cost, which is the product of a unit setup cost for product I in time t times a Boolean variable k, which has a value of 0 if no production is occurring, or 1 and only 1 if production is occurring. In this case, the problem is still linear, but some decision variables have to be integer, and therefore we are switching to a different set of mathematical programming, which is the mixed integer linear programming. This is much more complicated from a computational point of view, but much more powerful in terms of decision-making problems that you can tackle. As we've been discussing in this brief lecture, linear programming is a very simple and powerful and flexible approach to the development of the master production scheduling. And linear programming also helps in understanding the problem because it separates, it isolates the problem formalization from the numerical solutions. Once the problem has been formalized, you can use a lot of tools, both available in common personal productivity tools as well in specialized tools, in order to go from the model to the numerical solution. Of course, more complex problems, such as nonlinear problems in which cost may be depending on producer quantities or in which you have multiple conflicting objectives, still they do require more sophisticated approach and tools, which bring us to the field of advanced planning and scheduling systems. But for a lot of a real-life application, linear programming is very viable and very effective.